Pharmadigest channel. In today's session, again we will learn remaining part of nephelometry and turbidimetry. From the previous video in this series, you have already learned about introduction and basic principle of nephelometry and turbidimetry. Here you can find the link of that video. Today we will learn instrumentation and applications of same technique. So watch this video till the end and don't forget to subscribe our channel Pharmadigest.
Let's see instrumentation of turbidimeters and nephelometers. Turbidimeters, in most turbidimeters, ordinary colorimeters or spectrophotometers may be used. Any photometer, visual or photoelectric, can be turbidimeter without modification. Instrumental layout design includes lamp, lens, filter, primary polarizer, sample cell, photocell A and photocell B, half silvered mirror and crossed polarizer. In nephelometer, the same instrument as described above can also be used nephelometer. However, in this case, the instrument should have a suitable provision for adjusting source and detector at a right angle to each other. Mercury arc lamp or laser light are some of the commonest radiation sources used in nephelometric analysis. Tungsten lamp, which contains piece of tungsten wire which is heated in a controlled atmosphere. Filters will convert the polychromatic light to monochromatic light. Generally, filters are used for this purpose. Filters are of two types: absorption filters and interference filters. Cuvette or sample cells are used to hold the sample under interest and are generally made up of the transparent glasses. Geometrically may either be cylindrical or rectangular in shape. In general, a cell with a rectangular cross section is preferred, where measurements are to be made at angles other than 90 degrees. Semi-octagonal cells are widely used. In general, photovoltaic cells and phototubes are suitable for turbidimetric analysis, while sensitive photomultiplier tubes are ideal for nephelometric determinations. Sensitivity of the method is improved by the following: addition of water-soluble polymers gives greater stability of the immune complex, reduce reaction concentrations and increase sensitivity. The major difference between turbidimeter and nephelometer is the instrument it is used. In turbidimeter, plain spectrophotometer can be used. In nephelometer, nephelometry machines to be used. Another difference, that is type of light which is measured. In turbidimeter, it is transmitted light, and in nephelometer, it is a scattered light. The difference regarding the arrangement of photometer: in case of turbidimeter, it is made in the same direction as the propagation of the light from the source. In nephelometer, measure the light scatter at a right angle to the direction of the propagation of light from the source. So it could be a movable detector which allow operator to vary the angle of detection. Final clinical uses: for the turbidimeter, antigen-antibody reaction, immune complex reaction and precipitation reaction, protein in urine or cerebrospinal fluid detection. For nephelometer, same antigen-antibody reaction, immune complex reaction and precipitation reaction along with lipoprotein detection. Now let's learn about applications of nephelometry and turbidimetry. So it is used in determination of sulfate as a barium sulfate. It is used in the analysis of water for purity and for the detection of impurities. It is used in the determination of carbon dioxide. It is also used in determination of turbidity in the sugar products. It is used in the determination of clarity of citrus juices. It is used in the determination of benzene percentage in alcohol. It is used in the determination of amino acids, vitamins and antibiotics. It is used in determination of proteins. It is used in monitoring of the air and water pollution. It is used in turbidimetric titrations. Absorbance versus volume of titrant added is plotted in the titrations. And finally, it is also used in determination of molecular weight of the high polymers. This is all about applications of nephelometry and turbidimetry.
Thanks for watching this video. Please like this video and share this video with your friends. And please don't forget to subscribe our channel, Pharmadigest. Thank you.